this video, I'm going to show you how we can create this beautiful back to top button without any code. You just press on it, we go to the top, and it disappears, and it only appears when you start scrolling. The first thing we do is we log into our WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP admin, that's not a very safe way, so please watch my tutorial over here because you don't want to get hacked. Then go to edit a page on your website, which is pretty long, so we can see the scroll to top button in action. I assume you have created your website with Elementor Pro and you've also used the theme builder to create a header and all the way to the bottom a footer within the theme builder. That is important because you don't want to change every single individual page just for the scroll to top button. That's going to take you way too long. The first thing we're going to do is edit the footer. So we press on this icon over there. Then we're going to add in a new widget for our scroll to top button. You can use two widgets. A button would work, but also a icon. And I like this a little bit better. So we're just going to drag and drop it somewhere inside of your footer. It doesn't really matter where. You don't have to create a new container. Just drop it somewhere in a container. Now, first we're going to change the icon. So click on it. And then we're going to search for the arrow, something like this. Beautiful. Then press insert. Then we go to style in there. And then we can change the color that you want. Well, I want it to be dark. And on hover, I want it to be my orange color. So when I hover over it, it turns to this. Then we go to advanced. And then we go to position over here. We're going to click on it and change it to fixed, because we want this button to be always on the same place in our website. Whenever we scroll up or we scroll down, it has to stay fixed in the corner right there. Now let's scroll down just a little bit, and then we're going to change the horizontal orientation to the right side. We're going to change the vertical orientation also to the bottom. And there it is, on the bottom of our screen. And when I now scroll up in my website, you will see that this button will stay in the same place always, all the time. That's great. So let's change the offset of the horizontal and vertical orientation. If we change this, for example, to 50 pixels, also in here, you can see that the button is moving. And that's really nice. I want it to be a little bit closer to the side, let's say 25 pixels. And also I want it to be a little bit higher, so 100 pixels. Yeah, this looks pretty great. All right, you can of course change it to whatever you want on your website. Remember, it's your website. Then we have to make it work, so we have to put in a link in there. The link will be a hash, like this, and then you type in top. That's it, really simple, just hash top. If we then go to our header, just click on header over there, and then we want to save and leave. There we go. In your header, you want to go with the highest container. That will be this one in my case. If you open up the layers, you can see over here the highest container, like this. That should be our target for our button to scroll to, because we want to scroll it to top. We go to advanced, and we're going to give it an CSS ID without the hash. So this will be a top. There we go. Now just press on publish. And when I now preview my website, you can see this button always stays visible on the right side. It just works the way it should. And when I click on it, here we go. We are at the top. Also, when I go now to different pages, it's visible on every place, and it works because we have added it inside of the theme builder of Elementor. So this way it always works. But there's one thing we need to fix, because what I don't like is the button is always visible even when I am at the top. That's completely not necessary. So if we now want to edit the button, we have to go back to our footer. So we scroll all the way down, click on footer, and then we can click on the button. Now, to make it disappear while on top, you don't need any coding. It's very easy. You just go to advanced. We're going to close the layout and we go over here to motion effects. I really love this. Now, for this, you definitely need Elementor Pro, because you can do with the free version, you can do an entrance animation. It will just have a delay in seconds, but that's not what we want. What we want over there is we want a scrolling effect. Then we are going to click on transparency, because that is what we want. Click over here. Then we're going to change the direction to be fade in. Keep the level on 10, change the viewport bottom to 0%, and the top viewport, let's change it to 20%. Now, let me show you what will happen now. You can see it disappearing over there, and if we start scrolling, there we are. It's beautiful, and now it's just visible, but when you are on top, it just disappears, and that's the way how we want it. Now, the last important thing to do is to scroll up and to go to layout, and then we're going to give it a little bit more down over there, and we're going to change the Z index to 100, because it has to stay on top everywhere you go. If you don't have other elements on your website created with a higher Z index, then 100 is just great. Keep it like this. And when you are on mobile view again, also the button will appear and stay there. And I think this button is a little bit too high on my mobile version of my website. So how we changed it? Well, of course, we just go onto my footer over there and we're just going to edit it. We click on the button over here. And then on advanced, again, we scroll down and we go to the horizontal orientation and vertical orientation. And we can just change it for mobile only. Just put it a little bit down over there. We'll put it on 0, and then the offset on the side should be maybe 10. Now, this looks way better on our mobile device. Also do this for your tablet. Go over there and see if the horizontal orientation and offset is great. I think it's a little bit too high for also a tablet. So I'm going to change it again to 0 and 10. Make sure to do this for all your responsive devices. And when it's good, just press on publish. And that's it. If you want to learn how to create this beautiful e-commerce Elementor website, just go to this video and I'll show you step by step, really slow for the absolute beginner, how to create this beautiful working e-commerce website. If you have any questions, drop them down in the comments. I'll always reply. Have a great day. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you want to learn more about Elementor and WordPress. Have a great day. See you soon.